and welcome back to another edition of Capital Connection. Fridays during the noon report, we give you direct connection to what's happening in Albany and Harrisburg with the experts on the issues. The state capitals, they are Michael Gear at the Pennsylvania Family Institute and Jason McGuire at New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms. Jason, we'll begin with you. The budget deadline is midnight tonight. A lot of wheeling and dealing in those negotiations. And you know, Jason, you tell me all the time there's always a last-second Hail Mary that gets thrown in there. We understand there's a proposal now, tax the rich, that's been thrown into the mix as they try to reach a deal on a spending plan. Explain what's going on with those negotiations.
Yeah, every year we talk about the big ugly, and that's kind of the debated issues that need to be worked out before you can have a finalized budget. And certainly tax the rich is one of those. There's also the cashless bail that's still out there, the local control versus local control. All of those issues are kind of coming together, and we just don't know yet. I expect we're going to have a late budget. I've heard rumors of even a two-month extender. This could go on for some time, or they could decide to take all those issues out of there and just get the budget done. Right now, it appears as if the legislature feels emboldened and they want to roll this governor. The question is whether or not Governor Kathy Hochul has the spine to stand up to the legislature.
All right. Hey, let's head to Pennsylvania, Michael. John Fetterman has been missing in action for more than 6 weeks in the U.S. Senate. Are Pennsylvanians starting to wonder here if he's up to the job of being a senator? I know everyone on his staff says he's coming back soon, but where is the guy?
Well, first, I just want to express compassion for anyone, including Senator Fetterman, who is experiencing severe depression. That is a tragic and difficult situation to deal with. Same with him encountering the severe stroke that he did. Nevertheless, he's been in the hospital now for more than 40 days. The typical inpatient treatment for those suffering severe depression is about 6 days. So this is indicative of a very significant and severe problem. And Pennsylvania has been going without that seat being represented in the United States Senate. Now, there are questions about his ability to even carry out the job before the depression came along with the effects of his stroke. So I think lots of Pennsylvanians are saying maybe it's time for him to resign and to find a replacement.
Jason, a judge last week reined in the reach of New York's power to regulate faith-based schools. This impacts some 1,800 private schools in New York. If you would explain this decision and the impact it has on private and parochial education.
Well, listeners may recall that the State Education Department put out some regulations regarding substantial equivalency diplomas, or SED regulations. That really puts the screws on private schools across the state as far as having to be accountable to either the local district or some kind of enforcement mechanism if they were not meeting state standards. Well, the good news is that the court has now ruled this is the responsibility of the parents. And so the state can't really discipline the school for maybe not meeting all of the SED regulations because parents can get that other educational format through studies at home or other opportunities. So I'm encouraged that this decision really put education back in the seat of parents.
All right. Speaking of education, Michael, State Senator Doug Mastriano says public schools need to teach kids how to think, not what to think. Big difference there. Is his transparency in education effort, which basically makes schools put everything they do in the classroom online, is that the way to go here?
Well, interestingly, you know, this legislation is not the first time something like this has been introduced in the Pennsylvania General Assembly back in 2021, which is following, you know, all of the COVID shutdowns. Parents were calling for transparency, and a bill did pass both the House and the Senate, but Governor Wolf vetoed it. And I'm afraid if this bill gets traction this time around, that Josh Shapiro will do the same and veto the legislation. But it is important for parents to be able to know what's going on in the classroom, and this bill is a good effort in that direction, but we can see sort of where the sides play out on these education issues.
Yeah, it's an uphill battle all the way. Jason, it's been 3 years. Hard to believe 3 years. COVID that long, really, since New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedoms have been able to host an in-person Legislative Day event. Family Life, so proud to be able to help promote this. Yours is coming back in May. We might have a lot of listeners who don't know what Legislative Day is. Why are you so excited to be able to do this in person again?
Yeah, this is really the premier event for those politically involved and socially conservative in the faith-based community here in New York. It's a day-long conference. We have it at the Capitol, and so folks will have the opportunity to visit the Capitol, to meet with legislators, to go ahead and be educated on the issues. It has traditionally been the largest one-day conference of the year that's held in the Capitol complex, and we're excited to bring it back. We're looking forward to having Craig DeRoche of Family Policy Alliance with us, and many more speakers to be announced in the weeks to come, including a major announcement that we'll be telling you about before that May 23rd date.
Michael, it's been 10 years since the Dr. Kermit Gosnell scandal. Of course, this was the abortionist from Pennsylvania, his House of Horrors abortion clinic. What impact, 10 years, a decade since this mass murderer was convicted, what impact has this tragedy had on the abortion debate in your state?
It's been a significant impact. When the grand jury report came out about Kermit Gosnell and the House of Horrors there, it pointed out the abortion industry was regulated even less strictly than nail salons in Pennsylvania. And so the Pennsylvania General Assembly led an effort to put restrictions, unannounced inspections, and other health and safety regulations on abortion clinics to make sure that they lined up with other surgical facilities in Pennsylvania. And since then, quite a number of abortion clinics have shut down. But a lot of people have forgotten about Kermit Gosnell, and so we're going to be highlighting that trial in the 10-year anniversaries to remind people of what the abortion industry is really like.
And if you get a chance, watch the documentary 3801 Lancaster. That will open your eyes for sure, and that's all on your website as well. Guys, we would be remiss not to talk about what happened this week back on Monday, another school shooting, this one at a private Christian school in Nashville. Missouri Senator Josh Hawley, Jason, called this a hate crime. The president wouldn't go there, but he said if there's ever a definition of hate crime, this is it. How do you make sense of this when you look at who the shooter was here? The mental health issues plaguing our young people. Talk, if you would, to this issue as we kind of digest another tragic school shooting in this country.
Yeah, you know, I see it in two ways, because I see the Christian community responding to the issue of evil, and this was evil. There was evil that occurred here. It was a tragedy. And simply leaving it at that, not looking at what we can do to protect students and to take more positive solutions. On the other side, I see people that maybe aren't faith-based, that come from a governmental perspective or a political perspective, and all they're doing is seeing an opportunity to call for more gun control rather than really looking at some of the underlying issues. Mm. And I think somewhere between is both. As members of the Christian community, we should recognize that we have a spiritual adversary who comes to kill and destroy. That's what he wants to do. And I believe that's what occurred on this day. But then there were also some solutions. What can this school and others do to think about security going forward? How can they harden themselves? It's very rare for a female to be a school shooter, but this was a student who was actually, I believe, on male hormone treatment.
Yeah.
She was transitioning to try to identify as male. I don't know if that played a part in this, but these are questions that we're going to have to ask.
Yeah, this shooter, because of who the shooter was, Michael, and because of where the shooting took place, this was a transgender individual, and this was a Christian school. This shooter apparently was being treated for an emotional disorder. How do you make sense of what happened this week in Nashville?
It's hard to make sense of it, ultimately, except what Jason said, which is just ultimate evil. And the sinful heart of man creates these situations where, you know, from pretty much the beginning of our existence, there has been murder taking place, and you can't really explain it. But when you look at this situation, there's much more to be learned. I'm hopeful, certainly, that the police will release this manifesto so we have more of an understanding of what this individual was all about. But the fact that the president would not call it a hate crime points to the whole political nature of the whole concept of hate crimes, in that you can say, you know, this group we like, we're not going to call that a hate crime, that group we don't like, we will, creates a real problem. All murder is really at the heart of it is hate.
All right, and that's where we'll leave it there. Of course, prayers go out to Nashville. And we appreciate you both weighing in. Hey, get registered for New Yorkers for Constitutional Freedom's Legislative Day. It is back, folks. And you can find out more online. Jason, what's your website, sir?
OlbanyUpdate.com.
And read the article on Dr. Kermit Gosnell, 10 years later, why it's important to never forget what happened there. Michael, where can folks find that?
PAFamily.org.